Hello friends, hope you are doing well. So today we will discuss how indexing works in Commvault. We will discuss how Commvault indexing works and its methodologies. Well, our discussion on indexing may appear to be dry at first glance, but is actually very important in understanding how Commvault software provides resiliency and maximizes infrastructure efficiency in environments. There are four areas surrounding indexing that I will explain. As you are aware, the CommServe houses the CommServe database, a relational database built on SQL that contains much of the critical metadata for a CommServe environment. Information such as scheduling, storage policies, activity, media management, reporting, security, and encryption is housed in the CommServe database. It is important to note that the database only houses this lightweight metadata, which allows Commvault to maintain a small footprint for the database. Media agents are where the index cache and in many cases duplication databases are stored. For recommendations on sizing, index cache volumes are available on the Commvault documentation website. Hope you are aware of that. That is the documentation.commvault.com, and that has to be referred to for all of the sizing documents or all of the sizing recommendations. The index cache contains detailed job and object index information and characteristics. That means it contains the information exactly where a particular piece of data is being stored on a storage target device. The replication database maintains hash records for deduplicated storage policies. The index cache is maintained locally by the media agent themselves and automatically protected like the data itself to a storage target. So the question is, why does it matter? First of all, by distributing indexing across multiple layers, it minimizes the footprint of capacity consumed by the indexes. Even in very large environments, the CommServe database maintains a minimal footprint. This allows for portability and disaster recovery backups of the CommServe database and are easily conducted to remote locations over the WAN. A disaster recovery CommServe may be configured in a cluster environment or can be virtualized to minimize cost. Having said that, the fact that the index information is also returned to each storage target contributes to the resiliency of a Commvault software environment. In the case of a failure, a different media agent responsible for a secondary copy of the data will also contain all of the indexing information required to perform a recovery. So in a disaster recovery scenario, these capabilities which are provided by Commvault software, distributed indexing capabilities result in a highly accelerated time to data recovery. Many alternative solutions in the market have monolithic databases that can grow to a very large footprint. In a disaster situation, the advantage of the smaller CommServe database becomes apparent. When a disaster occurs, the first step is to recover the CommServe database. Because of its smaller footprint, the time required to restore this database is minimal. Once the database is restored, the console will communicate with the media agent, and the media agent will initiate the restoration of data and servers. So when directly compared to competitive solutions, customers see that the restoration process of their servers and the data on those servers is being initiated well before many competitive solutions have even finished destroying the database. This is a technical differentiator that has convinced customers many times and has won many POC engagements for Commvault. The efficiency of data restoration and the time to recovery are critical aspects when choosing a data management solution. So please like the video and subscribe to the channel and share your feedback in the comment box below. Hope you have understood the concept of indexing, how it works. Thank you.